And a lot of that actually was a ton of mobility. So mobility and flexibility, two different things. I don't know if people know that. But
Actually, for the fans, could you explain? I get that question a lot, but it'll be good to hear from your perspective, difference between flexibility and mobility, real quick.
yeah, so man, so flexibility and just keeping it kind of basic is, thinking about our muscles, right? Our muscles can contract and lengthen. So flexibility is a lot more of how well the muscle can lengthen, basically, if you can put it in that term. So if it's always tight, it's going to give you issues. You can compensate for different other parts of the body. So and our body optimally performs and functions when our muscles, in certain parts of the body that we're trying to get to fire up and go, can optimally perform, produce forces if they stay in a certain range where they can contract and lengthen effectively, right? So if your muscles, let's say in a microscopic level, our muscles are kind of overlap like this, right? Our muscle fibers. So if you're generally, so this is an optimal range, right? And if you're generally pretty tight, these muscles can maybe come together, maybe they're overlapped. So when they do contract, they have nowhere else to go, right? So that, let's say that little window is how much it can contract and produce forces, which is not a lot, right? So if we can make sure that we're in an optimal range, we have full contraction to produce whatever forces we need, right? And let's say if you're overstretched, there are people that overstretch. Maybe somebody who stretches way too much, does too much yoga. Maybe people who are mistaken a good warm-up with static stretching. So somebody is static stretching before performing, which is long holding stretches. And so let's say a sideline quad stretch, right? So instead of something like a butt kicker or a walking quad stretch, you do sideline, hold it for 30 seconds, a minute, two, whatever it is. So what happens is you take these fibers and you're lengthening it, right? So the what happens is they actually stay lengthened. You can still contract them, but they might stay this lengthened for, a good 24. Some studies have shown even up to 48 hours or something like that, right? So if it stays way too lengthened, then what happens is it can only contract so much, right? And because that window of contraction is, only so big, I'm not going to have an exact, like, what centimeters or how much it can contract. I don't know that, but when it does contract, it only goes so much. So our optimal range for where producing, let's say, forces are right here. Well, it can't get to there if it's pre-lengthened way too much, right? So when you do something like a butt kicker, high knees, walking knee hugs, you're slightly contracting. I mean, you're slightly lengthening and letting it come back, right? So you're kind of just giving it enough of a wake up call to be like, hey, I'm about to perform, compete, train over right now. I need you to wake up. I'm gonna place a little stress on you by stretching you a bit, but I'm not gonna do it way too much, right? So then the body's kind of hyped up and ready to go. And that's how you think you take a dynamic warm up and think in your mind, okay, I'm doing this dynamic warm up so that my muscles can just slightly lengthen and that I'm creating this environment where it can perform optimally, right? So that's with stretching, right? Just so people kind of have a, I guess, a depiction. And then mobility, it just comes down more to the joint, right? So mobility really comes down to how much range do I have at a certain joint or around a certain joint. And a lot of it comes with strength, right? A lot of times you can't get through certain ranges in your mobility because you don't have the strength to do so, right? And then what's interesting too is, they're interconnected. The more flexibility you have in general, the more mobility you have, right? So, but it doesn't also mean that athletes should go and stretch and do a ton of mobility all the time and not develop strength through those ranges. You want to be able to do both. And depending on the sport, like what's more beneficial, mobility or just being a little bit more rigid, right? So like a track athlete. So that's really, I hope that's a clear, pretty easy depiction or description of it.
Yeah, that's great. And then one thing I'll add to that is flexibility is a requirement for mobility, but I would say mobility, because your muscles do need to lengthen in certain positions to achieve a range of motion. But for most people, mobility, you will get sufficient flexibility from good mobility. So that's where I think mobility should be a greater focus, because naturally you will do some flexibility. But if you once you've achieved good mobility, you will retain enough flexibility for your sport, especially for jumpers. You need do need a little bit of tightness to shorten the time that you can contract. Too much flexibility will impinge that. So thanks for adding some of that. That was great.
Yep, I agree.